Good morning, students. So in the previous class, what we learned? We learned about the fractions, types of fractions we learned, and addition of fractions, subtraction of fractions, multiplication of fractions, division of fractions all we learned yesterday. And we have done the bits also. Next, we are going to the next topic, decimals. Okay, in IIT, what is the next one? Next topic is decimals. What are called decimals, children? What are called decimals? Fractions with denominators 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, so on are called decimal fractions. Fractions with denominators 10, 100, 1000, so on is there, no? That fractions are called decimal fractions. That means any power of 10. Suppose 4 by 10 is there. Okay. 5 by 10 square. 10 square means how much? 100, 5 by 100, 5 by 10 square means how much? 5 by 100. So any power of 10 is there in the denominator, those fractions are called decimal fractions. Okay, already we learned in types of fractions, what are called decimal fractions. Okay, and next, see here in page number 24 IIT book, the word decimal comes from Latin word. The word decimal comes from Latin word decem. Decem meaning means 10. The decimal system helps us to place fractions in the place value chart. To find place for fractions, the place value chart is extended to the right of the unit's place. Because the place value of a digit decreases to 110 as the digit moves by 1 place left to right. So what is the place value chart, children? In decimal fractions. Suppose this is 1. Here, tens place, next, hundreds place, next, thousands place is there. Okay, so from moving to left side, it will be decreases 10 times. It will be, sorry, it will be increases 10 times. While we are moving to right hand side, what will become? It will decreasing 10 times. That means 1 by 10, 1 by 100, 1 by 1000. While we are moving left side, it will be increases 10 times. While we are moving right side, it will decreasing 10 times. See here, 1000 is there. Now I am moving to right side. It will be decreasing 10 times. That means 100. Again, I am moving right side. It will decreasing 10 times. That is 10. Now I am moving right side. It will decreasing 10 times. It will become 1 place. Next, 1 by 10th. 1 by 100th, 1 by 1000th. How can you read 1 by 10? 1 by 10th, 1 by 100th, 1 by 1000th. This is the place value chart, children. Okay. Next, how can you read this one? 8.567 is there. How can you read this one? 8.567. After decimal point, you should read the numbers individually. That means 8.567. Like that you should read. Don't read 8.567. Okay. After decimal point, you should read the numbers individually. 8.567. And what is called before decimal point? Before decimal point, what do you call this one? Whole number part. What do you call? Whole number part. Okay. Whole number part. Before decimal point, where the number is there, that number is called whole number part. And after decimal point, the numbers are there. What do you call that one? Decimal part. What do you call? Decimal part. Before decimal point, that one called whole number part. After decimal point, that numbers are called decimal part. And what do you call this dot? Decimal point. Did you understand now? Before decimal point is called whole number part. After decimal point is called decimal part. And this point is called decimal point. And how to read this number? 8.567. Don't read 8.567. Okay, ma? After decimal point, you should read the numbers individually. 8.567. Like that you should read. Next, rules for significant figures. In a whole number, all the digits are significant. In the whole numbers, all the numbers are significant. Whole numbers means before the decimal point, what do you call whole numbers? No. So these numbers are called significant. What do you call? Significant. Next. In a decimal number greater than 1, all the non-zero digits and zeros between them are significant. So in the decimal number, suppose here, I will tell one example. What do you call this one? This is a decimal number. Why? Because here decimal point is there, no. That's why we call it as decimal number. And this is whole number part, this is decimal part, and this is decimal point. And for this number, what do you call? Decimal number. Okay? What do you call this one? Decimal number. So in the decimal number, it is greater than 1 or not? Yes, it is greater than 1. 2 is greater than 1 or not? Yes, it is greater than 1. So it is greater than 1. All the non-zero digits and zeros between them are significant. So all the, this is greater than 1. So all the digits are significant. Okay. So here what are the significant digits? 2, 0, 7, 3. These are significant digits. How many digits are there here? 4 digits. 4 significant digits are there. Did you understand? Next rule. In a decimal number lying between 0 and 1, the initial zeros are not significant. In a decimal number, see one example, 0.004. It is a decimal number. It is less than 1 or greater than 1. 0 is always less than 1. So, in the decimal number, it is less than 0 is there, less than 1 is there. So here you have to, here how many significant figures are there? You didn't count zeros. Okay. So how many significant figures here? Only 1 number. What is that number? 4. So how many significant number is there? Only 1 number. Significant is 4. 1 digit only. Did you understand? If it is greater than 1 means you should take all the numbers as significant. But here it is less than 1. Okay, so that's why significant is only 1 number, that is 4. Next rule, in a corrected decimal number, the final zeros are significant. The final zeros are significant. That means you have to take one example, 0.070. It is also less than 1. It is also less than 1. So what are the significant figures here? You didn't take left side zeros. You have to take only right side of the number, zero. Okay. So here what are the significant figures? 2 are there. What are those? 7, 0. How many significant figures are there? 2. What are those? 7, 0. Did you understand? So significant means what? Whether the number is greater than 1, all the digits are significant. So here it is greater than 1. That's why significant figures, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. What are those? 2, 0, 7, 3. Next rule is, if it is less than 1, you don't count the left side of zeros. So here only 1 number, 4. So significant is 4. It is also less than 1. But here, right side 0 is there. So here how many significant? 2, 7, 0. Okay, did you understand significant children? Any doubts, ma? Now we are going to the next topic, expanded form of decimals. Expanded form. What do you call expanded form? What is called expanded form, children? It will be stretched out. That means you have to sum of the digits of the place value. Okay. That means a number can be written in expanded notation by writing an expression that shows the sum of the values of each digit. Sum of the values of each digit. Suppose see 47.8356 is there. You can write in expanded form. How can you write, children? 4 is in which place here? Tens place. So 4 into 10 plus 7. 7 is in which place? 1's place. 7 into 1 plus next decimal point after. What is the number? 8. So 8 is in which place here? 1 by 10's place. That means 10's place. 8 by 10. 8 into 1 by 10 plus 3. Which place it is? 100th place. So 3 into 1 by 100 plus 5. 5 is in which place, children? 1000th place. So 5 into 1 by 1000 plus 6. 6 is in which place, children? 10,000th place. So 6 into 1 by 10,000. Did you understand how to write expanded form? 4 is in 10th place, so 4 into 10. 7 is in 1's place, 7 into 1. Plus decimal point after 10th place, so 8 into 1 by 10. 3 into 1 by 100. 5 into 1 by 1000. 6 into 1 by 10,000. Okay, like that you should write. Next here, note is given, see. In decimal, the place value of a digit decreases 10 times from the decimal point to the right. So in a decimal, the place value of a digit decreases. When we are moving to right side, it decreases 10 times. Okay. The decimal digits are read one by one. The decimal digits you can read one by one. That means individually you should write. Read. See here, example 253.847. Like that you should write. Next, comparison of numbers. Comparison. How to compare the numbers? Here decimal numbers are there now. How to compare? Comparison of decimals is done by comparing the size of whole number part followed by tens, hundreds, thousands and so on. Let us go one example. 24.93, 21.87 is there. Among these two numbers, which one is greater? How you should compare the two? First you should compare whole number part. What are the whole number part here? 24. Here whole number part is 21. Which is greater? 24 and 21. 24 is greater. So it is greater than this number. Okay. Next. 48.798. Next. 48.647. So first you should compare whole number part. Here whole number part is 48. Here also 48. Both are equal. Now we are going to the tens place. After decimal, what is the first place? Tens place. What is the tens place here? 7. Here 6. Which one is greater? 7 or 6? 7 is greater. So this number is greater. Okay, ma'am. Next, 21.749. Whole number part you have to check it first. Here 21, here also 21. Both are equal. Next, after decimal point, tens place is 7. Here tens place is 7. Both are equal. Next, hundreds place is here 4. Here hundreds place is 4. Here 6, here 4. Which one is greater? This one is greater. Okay, like that you should compare the decimals. First you should compare the whole number part, then both are same is you should move to the tens place, that one also same is you should move to the hundreds place, like that you should go on like that. Next, like decimals, unlike decimals and their conversion. What are called like decimals, children? Like decimals means what? The decimals having the same number of digits on the right of decimal point are known as like decimals. So decimals having the same number of digits, that means example C 1.1, 20.5, 312.5. So here all the numbers are different, but after decimal point, how many digits are there here? One digit. Here also one digit. Here also one digit. After decimal point, all decimals having only one digit. So these are called like fractions. Did you understand that? These are called like decimals. Like decimals. And unlike decimals means different different number of digits are there. 20.56, 1.5, 36.001. Here, observe. After decimal point, how many digits are there? Two digits. Here, one digit. Here, three digits. All are different. So these are called unlike decimals. Did you understand the like decimals means after decimal point number of digits are same, and unlike decimals means number of digits are different. These are called unlike decimals. These are like decimals. Okay. Next, conversion of unlike decimals into like decimals. How to convert unlike decimals to like decimals, children? It's very easy. See here, which one is the highest one? This is the highest, 36.001. This is now 1.5 convert into like decimal. How you should write? You should write 1.5 after two digits, you should keep zeros. Then it will be same. Like decimal will get. And this one also, 20.56. Not there another place, so you should write 0. Like that, you should convert unlike decimals to like decimals. Did you understand that? You should keep the zeros on the right side. We will convert unlike decimals to like decimals. Did you understand that? So did you understand now? Like decimals and unlike decimals. Now we are going to the next topic, addition of decimals and subtraction of decimals. Add 5.4, 12.84, 115.2. Add 5.4, 12.84, 115.2. How can you add, children? These are all like decimals or unlike decimals? How to know these are all like decimals or unlike decimals? We should check after decimal point. Here, how many digits? Only one digit. Here, two digits. Here, one digit. So these are all unlike decimals. First, you should convert into like decimals. First, you should write 5.4, next 12.84, 115.2. So you should, how to convert unlike decimals to like decimals? You should keep the zeros to the right side of the number. So here 0, here 0. Now they will convert into like decimals. Now you have to add. So 0 plus 4, 4, 4 plus 0, 4. 4 plus 8, 12. 12 plus 2, 14. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 5, 13. See, your decimal point is in a put the decimal point. 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 1. So, what is the answer? 133.44. Here, you should write the numbers 1 by 1. Okay. Then only you'll get right answer. 5 is in 1's place. So here 2 is in 1's place. 5 is in 1's place. Right? So we should keep it like that. So 133.44 is the answer. Okay. Now subtraction. Subtract 25.96 from 51.2. So what is the question here? Subtract 25.96 from 51.2. So from this number, you should write first 51.2, 25.96. So here also, unlike decimals is there. First you should convert into like decimals. How to write? You should keep the zeros on the right side. So keep 0. Now subtract. Can you subtract 6 from 0? Can you subtract? No. So you should take borrow from here. 1. Here 10. 10 minus 6, 4. 1 minus 9. Can you subtract 9 from 1, children? No. Again, you should take bar over here. 11. 11 minus 9. How much? 2. Again, you should take bar over here. 10. 10 minus 5. 5. 4 minus 2. 2. So, what is the answer? 25.24. Did you understand, ma'am? Addition and subtraction of decimals. Addition and subtraction of decimals. Did you understand, children? Next topic is multiplication of decimals. Multiplication of decimals. So how to multiply? Suppose see here example, 2.784 into 10 is there. Okay, 2.784 into 10 is there. How can you multiply this one, children? Here 10 is there. So how many zeros? 1 zero. So if you multiply with 10, we will move the decimal point more to the right side of 1 digit. Why? Because here 1 zero now. So this decimal point moved to the right side. So this decimal point comes to here. So what is the answer? 27.84. Okay. Suppose same this one, you should multiply with 100. Where the decimal point moves? Here two zeros are there now. So this decimal point moved to the right side two digits. So here 7, 8 after will come. So 278.4. Suppose same number you should multiply with 1000. What is the answer? Here 3 zeros are there. So the decimal point moved to the right side of 3 places after. So 2784. Did you understand, ma'am? How to do multiplication with 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 like that? Okay. Next, multiplication of decimal by whole number. If you take whole number, 3.25 into 12. This is not a 10, 100, not 10 purpose, not there. Only whole number 12 is there. How can you multiply this one? 12 fives, how much children? 60. 6 is remaining. 12 twos, 24. 24 plus 6, how much? 30. 3 is remaining. 12 threes, 36. 36 plus 3, how much? 39. Now, where you should keep the comma, children? Where you should keep the comma? Observe here. We have decimal point after how many digits? 1, 2. 2 digits are there. Okay. So, you should keep the comma from right side onwards. 2 digits after you should keep comma. 1, 2. So, here you should keep comma. So, what is the answer? 39.00 means? After decimal point zeros, no value is there. So what is the answer? 39 is the answer. Did you understand, ma'am? Next, multiplication of decimal by decimal. Decimal by decimal. How can you multiply? How can you multiply? Both are decimal points are there, decimal numbers are there. How can you multiply? See, observe here. This is 2 digits, this is 3 digits, no? First, you should remove the decimal point. You should remove the decimal point, 607 into 92. Directly, you should multiply. 2 sevens, 14. 2 zero zero, 1. 2 six, 12. One digit keep the gap. 9, 7, 63. 9, 0, 0 plus 6, 6. 9, 6, 54. Now add 4, 4, 8, 5, 5. What is the answer we'll get? 5, 5, 8, 4, 4 we'll get. Now, where you should keep the commas? Where you should keep the dot, decimal point? how to do? See here. You can count right side of the decimal point. 1, 2, 1, 2. Here, 3. How many digits are there? 1, 2, 3. After decimal point, how many digits are there? 1, 2. Here, 3. 3 digits. So you should keep the decimal point from right side onwards. You should keep the decimal point after 3 digits. So 1, 2, 3. So you should keep the comma here. So what is the answer? Keep the dot here. 55.844. Did you understand, ma'am? Any doubts, students?